about a month, month and a half, but I always enjoy myself when they come. I enjoy myself. And it's no different today. In the Word of God, if you have your Bibles and you can study, would you stand with me, please? In Daniel, the book of the prophet Daniel. It's good to see y'all out there today.
Yeah.
Don't y'all stop coming to church. There's strength.
Yes.
There's encouragement. In the book of Daniel, chapter 6. Daniel comes after Ezekiel. And chapter 6, I shall start reading at verse 18. Then the king went to its palace and passed the night fasting. There were instruments of music brought before him, and his sleep went from him. Then the king arose very early in the morning and went in haste unto the den of lions. And when he came to the den, he cried with a lamentable voice unto Daniel. And the king spake and said to Daniel, O Daniel, servant of the living God, is thy God whom thou servest continually able to deliver thee from the lions? Then said Daniel unto the king, O king, live forever. My God hath sent his angel and hath shut the lions' mouths.
Hallelujah.
That they have not hurt me. For as much as before him innocency was found in me, and also before thee, O king, have I done no hurt. Then was the king exceeding glad for him, and commanded that they should take Daniel up out of the den. So Daniel was taken up out of the den, and no manner of hurt was found upon him, because he believed in his God.
Yes.
And then you may be seated. I would especially like to call your attention to verse 20. Verse 20. And when he came to the den, talking about the king here now, he cried with a lamentable voice unto Daniel. And the king spake and said unto Daniel, O Daniel, servant of the living God.
Yes.
Listen to this, listen to this, listen to this. Is thy God whom thou servest continually able to deliver thee from the lions? If I had a subject, the text, and I knew, it would be a question. I don't mind asking questions. That question would be, is the God whom you serve continually able to deliver you from the lions? To set the things in perspective, Daniel had been praying. Daniel was a righteous man. Daniel was a man that feared God, that loved God, was in the graces of God.
Yes,
yes. He was of the Lord. He was saints. But somewhere, something back at Thessalonica, it struck me, Demas wanted to go back to something in Thessalonica. He left and went back into the world. I want you to know that if you're sitting there and you're not saved today, if you saw somebody that went back into the world that said that they were saved, don't you let that discourage you.
That's right.
If you want to stay saved, Jesus is able to keep that which you commit unto him.
Praise the Lord, yeah.
If you want to be saved, don't you worry about coming to Jesus. He's able to save you.
Amen.
He's able to keep you saved.
Amen.
And he's able to let you know And I can do it all, but the scripture was read. And my arm is not short, and it cannot see.
That's right.
Who read that scripture? And my ear is not heavy, and it cannot hear. Have you called on it?
That's right.
Have you called on it? He said, call unto me, and I will answer thee. You might call your mama, she might not answer. Your husband, she might not answer. Your best friend, she might not answer. But I want you to know that Jesus said, call unto me, and I will answer you.
Amen.
And I will show thee great and mighty things which thou knowest not. Is the God whom you serve, is he able to deliver you and to deliver you from the lion? People try to serve God, but they don't serve him continually. People try to serve God, but they serve him off and on. People try to serve God as a matter of convenience. They put him again on Sunday, they got it, and it's like they put him on the shelf on Monday. But I know, I'm going to say something. I don't think they had him on Sunday.
That's right.
This God that I know, he doesn't come and go like that. This God that I'm talking about, make sure you got this God. He's a very present help in times of trouble. This God, Jesus, he said he will never leave you nor forsake you. You got a God somewhere. And you need to examine yourself, whether you be in the faith. This God whom you serve, and you do serve a God, is he able to deliver you from the lion? You can serve him at an old age, but I hope you don't try to wait till you get old, because he didn't promise you you were going to get old. You would do well to serve him at a young age, and he can save you at a young age, and keep you through a teenager year, and keep you into adulthood, and he can keep you when you're an old man.
That's right.
And I want you to know that when you go to the grave, he ain't going to forget you there. He's going to bring you out, bring you into his presence.
That's right.
This guy that I'm talking about, he's a very present help in time of trouble.
That's right.
This guy that I'm talking about, he's never lost the case. Oh, Daniel. Is the God on our service able to deliver you?
Yes, thank you.
You need to examine yourself and see who you're serving. What are your goals? What are your interests? What are your determination? We're in the first Sunday of the year, aren't we?
Yes.
He brought you through last year.
That's right, amen, he did.
52 Sundays. He brought you through last year.
Every year, every Sunday, every week.
Can you guarantee that the God that you serve is going to do that again? Nobody did that but Jesus.
Nobody.
And if you're here today and you're not saved, you went through 52 Sundays or 52 weeks last year and you didn't get saved, you didn't bring yourself through, you didn't make it by luck. Ain't no such thing as luck.
That's right. That's
right. I tell people, and they say luck is a lady. I guess because it's so fickle, it's so unchanging, it's so changeable, it's so unpredictable. I'm not trying to insult anybody. They said luck. I heard somebody say luck is a lady. You can't predict luck. You can't program luck.
That's right.
You can't say how luck is going to go from day one day to another. They said luck is a lady. I want you to know something. You better not be depending on luck. Because if luck is a lady, I want you to know something. Every lady is going to die.
Right.
Your luck is going to run out one day. But the God that I'm talking about, he's the same today, yesterday, and forever. And he's able to keep you and to keep you from falling. Oh, Daniel, is that God whom thou servest able to deliver you? Well, we started out the first Sunday of the year. The question I want you to hold on to, starting out right now, who is your God? There's a couple of questions. And is he able to deliver you? If you didn't make it to the end of the year, is your God able to deliver you? If you didn't make it to next Sunday, do you have a God that's able to deliver you? Well, I know a God that's able to deliver you. And once he delivers you, he's able to keep you from falling. I know a God that's come to seek and to save that which is lost. Stand up with me if you would. Yes. I know a God who's come to seek and to save that which is lost. You were born in sin. I was born in sin. In sin where we conceived. But I know a man who was not conceived in sin. He was conceived and his father was the Holy Ghost. Everybody in here, our father was Adam. And Adam sinned. And everybody that came from the seed, that's every one of us, we were born in sin. But I know a man who was not conceived in sin. His father was the Holy Ghost. He was pure, free from sin. I'm talking about Jesus in case you don't know. This man came to seek and to save those who were lost through Adam's sin and our own sins. This man came to pay the price for your sins and my sins. This man came knowing that the price to be paid had to be paid in blood because God required a pure blood sacrifice.
Amen.
Untainted lamb. There was none that worthy.
That's
right. There was none able to do this for Jesus. This man came about 2,000 years ago. This man that came to deliver you, to deliver me, he did not come to deliver himself. He was made to be sin for us who knew no sin.
Right.
This man, Jesus, who came to deliver us, he's still delivering today. He started delivering about 2,000 years ago to pay the price of blood for your sins and my sins. He went to the cross, having done no sin, having done no unrighteousness. They nailed him to the cross, but when he died, after paying the price, he died, they buried him, and he rose again.
Amen.
With all power in heaven and earth in his hands. You're going to need a father that's got some power. You're going to need a father that's not going to die like your natural father. You're going to need a father that's an everlasting father. And that man is Jesus. Unto us a
Amen.
Child is born. Unto us a son is given. And the government shall be upon his shoulders. And his name shall be called Wonderful, Counselor, the Mighty God, the Everlasting Father. And the Prince of Peace.
Amen.
I'm so glad he's the Everlasting Father.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
You got some tricks, some DNA from your father, and you're going to die because if he's not already dead, he's going to die.
That's right.
But I want you to know that you can have another father. That at first, that natural father was not an everlasting father. Jesus is the Everlasting Father. You can have another father. He can deliver you from the jaws of death. The God that you serve. Is he able to deliver you from the lion? There's some lions out there. They might be waiting on you before you get home. He might cross the double yellow line.
Amen.
He might go through an intersection and hit you broadside. He might be a heart attack. He might be a house catching on fire in the middle of the night. He might be a straight bullet that hits you in the head. He might be a madman that's going around hurting women and men and children. But I want you to know God is able to keep you.
Amen.
If you would trust in him continually. Is there anybody here that doesn't have the Everlasting Father? Is there anybody here that doesn't have the God who is able to deliver them? I wish you would come forth and let me talk with you there. You need this God who is able to keep you. You need this only God that's able to keep you. You need this only God that's willing to keep you. You need this God because if you don't take him, if you don't want to come to him now, you're going to come to him later on the other side of the grave. And if you wait until you get on the other side of the grave to come to this God, it's going to be a waiting too late. If you wait till you're on the other side of the grave, you can't get saved on the other side of the grave. If you die a sinner on this side of the grave, you're going to come out of the grave a sinner on the other side of the grave. You need Jesus, and you need Jesus now. You need Jesus today. O Daniel, is that God whom thou servest continually able to keep you from the lion? I'm looking around quite a number of young people here. I don't know if they're saved, but I want you to know that God is still saving.
Amen. Yes, he is.
Seems like y'all paying attention. That's good.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Most of y'all. Is God whom you serve? Is he able to keep you? What are you depending on to keep you?
What are you depending on to keep you? I'm not wishing anybody bad things. Your mother can't keep you. She can do her best. She can't keep herself unless God kept her.
That's right.
Your father can't keep you. Your pistol can't keep you. Your watchdog can't keep you. You can't keep yourself. Oh, I buckle up. A whole lot of dead people been pulled out of the cars, still buckled in. Oh, I eat right. A whole lot of people eat right and still die of sickness.
That's right.
Oh, I get put in the streets. Do you have Jesus? Have you repented of your sins? Maybe I just need to close. Have you repented of your sins? Have you been baptized in the name of Jesus Christ for the remission of sins? Have you received the gift of the Holy Ghost? The Holy Ghost is Jesus. When you've got Jesus, you've got the best there is. There is none better. If you've got anything less than Jesus, he's unable to keep you. Is there one? Not one? All right, then you might be seated. I guess.
I'm going to need him.
Thank you, Lord, for the message.
You're going to need him. Think about the God you serve.
Yes, thank you, Lord.
Ask yourself, this God that you serve, and you serve a God.
Yes.
That's right.
Is he able to keep you? You might say, well, he's kept me up to here. That was Jesus.
Yes.
So that you can come home. So that you can get right. And be kept forevermore. The fact, the truth that you made it through last year.
Yes.
That was not salvation. If you're not saved, if you made it through last year, that was not the salvation of the Lord. That was the mercy of the Lord.
Amen. Yes. That was his mercy. Yes, it was.
And he's merciful to the dogs and guests.
Yes, that's right.
Maybe I'll quit.
Yes, thank you, Lord. Okay. Thank you, mighty God. Anybody want to be prayed for? Come right on up.
Come on up.
That's a good message.